this workshop is going to be structured. I'm going to take half the time to go over some more advanced topics from the previous workshop. So I'll explain what those are, and then the other half of the time is just kind of general help sessions. So I know that all your projects are probably really diverse and different, so I'm gonna try and just hop between teams, or you can come up to me and I'll try and figure out like specific solutions to your problems. Okay, so to those who haven't met me yet, I'm Joanna. I'm studying computer engineering at Waterloo right now, and I've done a lot of Android and a lot of iOS at multiple software engineering internships. So if you want to ask me about internships at the end too, happy to do that. Okay, so what we're going to talk about in the advanced topics are the Android lifecycle. I'm going to talk a little bit about intents and being able to communicate with within a multi-activity Android project, as well as a bit on async tasks. If you've heard of async tasks before, they can be quite a pain. It's for doing background tasks, and it can get confusing with like different threads. But we can go with that. Okay, so Android lifecycle. This is important to know if you have different things running at different points of the lifecycle, because if you have something that was created in OnStart or OnCreate and then it suddenly disappears or your app crashes, it might be because it got dumped away somewhere. So how it works is the activity is launched, you have your onCreate, so here you'll want to initialize any of your UI elements, and then onStart, you would be actually starting the activity. So this is after you've created all your UI elements, you want to actually start doing whatever you want to do, like maybe animate something, on resume, on pause, this is a loop, you can go into the background, go back into the app, you have those. On stop, this is when the activity is no longer visible, so you stop it, and then on destroy, this is when everything is like completely done, your Android program is destroyed, and then they're shut down. Okay, so now that we've done that, the main piece of the information that I'm going to give you is how to have another activity. So in Android 1, we only had a single activity app. And if you've used any apps before, you know that most of them are not just single activity, you have multiple activities. And with multiple activities, because they're on different, all the logic is on different Java files, you'll need to communicate between the activities because you want one cohesive app. So to do that, we have intents. So these are asynchronous messages that allow these components to be able to talk to each other. You can request functionality and you can add extra data in something called a bundle, which I'll show you in a bit. So what you can use intents for would be to open another activity. So if you're on one activity, you press a button or something, you wanna add, you wanna display another activity with like a map or something, you can do that. Cool, let's go in to some code. So I already have an activity here. Okay, so we have our main activity, and I'm going to create something called other activity, and I'm going to be creating an intent to open that activity on a click of a button. So the button was already created in Android 1. If you don't know how to create a button, we can go over that after in like a help session. Okay, so this is how we create an intent. Fairly straightforward. So we have the class intent, we're going to call it I, to create a new intent, and then we have this and another class. So this is your current content. So for us, it would be main activity, and then the second parameter is the activity that you want to be sending the intent to. So this might be kind of confusing, but that next one, the second parameter, will be called other activity. And then the second line, i.putExtra, that is hashing some values. So we have a key here. So the left side is a key, and the right side is the value. So we're putting that into the intent. And we're putting it inside the intent as a bundle, which we would unwrap afterwards. So I'll show you that. And then when we call startActivity, we call the intent, and it will start a new activity of the second argument up here, which we will call other activity. So let's go ahead and do that. So intent, I create a new intent, and other activity dot class. So other activity is not yet made, that's why it's red, but we will make it. We have our key, we have our value. And we can start the activity with I. But we want to start the activity inside of our onClick listener. So we would think that we could just copy that. Paste it here, but we can't. But we can't do that because this is inside of an inner class. We could declare a final. We can do that, and then it'll be good. So that starts other activity that we have yet to make. So let's do that. If anyone has any questions at any point, just raise your hand. Yeah?
And what does final mean?
Final means that you're not changing it. So because in this case, our intent is just opening another activity, we set it to be other activity already. So you don't need to change it.
In this case, is I just a pointer pointing at the intent object, and then it just final means that you can't change what the pointer is pointing at?
Essentially. Okay, so we need to create another activity that's pretty much the exact same as main activity. So how we do that, we're going to go into our source folder here, click new, Java class, and we're going to name it other activity. Okay, so now we have blank activity here. So we need our onCreate method, same as here. So we're just going to copy and paste. And we have a good good working activity there. So back here, I put some extra values inside of the intent, and I call that a bundle. So you can see here that when you onCreate, you're actually passing in a bundle called save instance state. So back in main activity, when we called start activity and we passed in I, which was our intent, we are passing that into other activity as save instance state. So we would want to unpack save instance state to access the value that we passed in. But some other housekeeping things that we need to do. We need to add other activity to our Android manifest so that it actually exists inside of our application. So Android manifest is essentially any configuration things that you need for the app.
Would you make it bigger?
Yeah. So this is the Android manifest. I just can't navigate anywhere. I'll try to go in whenever I'm typing anything. Okay. So, yeah, here we're gonna add our other activity like that, and then we're good to go. So that's all you need to add in the Android manifest, and then here we'll need to create a new layout XML, and so to do that, we're gonna set the content view just like we did with main activity. We have r.layout activity main. We're gonna create a new layout file, layout resource file. We're gonna call it activity other. And let's use our root element as a linear layout, just like that. Okay, and we're gonna come to this view where we're gonna do text. And let's just set a text view, wrap content. We're gonna set an ID. Want to call this text. Let's call it level text. But that's what we're going to use it for. Cool. So this is our new XML. Just simple linear layout text view. And then now we're going to go back and we're going to set our content view. r.layout.other. Okay. Cool. So we have a text view. We have our other activity. Let's go ahead and actually get this text view. So text view. ID, r.id, we call it bundle text. Okay. And now we want to populate that text view with the bundle extras that we passed in. So how do we do that? We need to receive the intent. So we call all of this bundle extras, get intent, get extras. So that's getting the extras, and then lines 2 to 4 say if the extras are empty, then just ignore it, whatever. if it's not empty, then we would get the actual value from it. And extras.getString, that is the key there, value one, who we call the key, or I call the key. And then if the value is not null, then do something with that data. In our case, we're going to try and populate that text view. Let's do that. Is everyone at this point? Good? Maybe? Problems?
What is a bundle?
What's a bundle?
Yeah.
It's pretty much just a package of data. Yeah. If you want to know more about the specifics of bundle, you could look at the implementation of bundle. By Android, or just like look up documentation. But generally, it's packages of data. Okay, so if you're at this point, everything should work. So let's try running that. So we have a button, and this button, when pressed, should bring us to a new activity, and it should have a text view that says, value. Cool. Who says value there? So in the context of a project, you'd be able to pass anything you want if you're making like a health app or something, you can pass through like numbers, blood pressure numbers, through to another app, display that in a pretty way, anything you like. Just like that. Any questions about starting a new activity or intents? Okay. Yeah.
How does other activity know which intent to get? Like when you do bundle extras equals get intent, where is it getting the intent from? Where is it it's getting from this?
So you know how we called start activity?
Yeah.
We start an activity with a certain intent, right? We're not starting like that activity simultaneously through different channels.
Okay.
So that intent that you started the activity with.
Oh, sorry, so are we just going back to the last page? Just wanted to copy that down.
Sure.
Oh, wait. So if I'm understanding this correctly, you create an intent with the other activity, right? And then when you start an activity with that intent, it starts the other activity.
Yes. That is not the only way. There's like a lot of libraries out there, but I find that intent is the easiest because it's like the most base level. Is there like a specific way you wanted to communicate between activities?
I just wanted to figure out like something easy for
think this is probably the easiest, one of the easiest, yeah. Okay. Is everyone good? I'll give like one more minute. Okay, I'm gonna go a little bit into async tasks because I think that it's really useful for a lot of things. And then I'll just do a help session for everyone. Okay, so what is async task? I think that async task has fairly good documentation online. So if you wanna go into detail, if you actually wanna use it, go there. I'm just gonna be explaining what it is and introducing it. So it is good for background tasks. So if you need to do any kind of processing of like data or images might be kind of heavy, but like any kind of calculations in the background before you do anything else or you want to do something simultaneously, async task is good. So how you would use it? Fairly simple. To list out the steps, but when implementing, problems arise. But I'm sure you can deal with it. So first you just import async task by Android. You have some generic types for your task runner. So we see there are three parameters here. The parameters for the async task. Progress and result, and then you need to override some methods. So what are those methods? You have on pre-execute, you have do in background, that's where the parameters come in. So you take in those parameters and you do whatever computations that you want to do. So those will be done on the background thread. So it won't be blocking anything else. So that's really useful. If you have something that might take like a while, like a minute or something, you don't want that blocking your UI. You want that running in the background and then just updating the UI when you can. Or you could also use on progress update. So that would be the progress. And you would get that. So you wouldn't be calling on progress update. Async task runner will be doing that for you, so you will be getting that progress, and when you take that, you can display that in UI. So you can say, okay, I'm almost done, I'm still computing, just so the user knows. Just good user experience to know that the app isn't just frozen. And then on post execute, you get the actual result of your computation. So this can be in the form of a lot of different things. It could be like integer, string, whatever you want. Read more on the documentation if you want specific details, but you'll get the result of the background computation and you'll be able to do whatever you want, like display the data or run the next task that you want. So that's async task. And that's it for Android 2. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Otherwise, I'll just be holding open office hours now.